So Gary Ablett announced his retirement today. Is he the greatest Christian, born-again Christian, to ever play the game of AFL? Well, probably like a bunch of you, I grew up watching his father, Gary Ablett Sr., play, probably one of the greatest players ever. And it's very rare for a son to come along in any elite sport and outdo his father. But possibly Junior, Gary Ablett Jr., has done that. 2 Brownlow medals, 8 All-Australians, 6 club bests and fairest, and 2 premierships. And he's going to retire on Saturday with his boyhood team, the Cats, possibly winning another grand final. Absolutely phenomenal. But the thing that's always amazed me is his Christian faith. It's often come through strongly. It definitely comes through on his Instagram feed, where he lives out his Christian faith without compromise, and he's not afraid of that being in the public eye. You often see his Christian character in the way he acts and does things and carries himself, even the way he came back from the Perth hub this year to be with his family because his son was sick. It's very, very interesting. And in 2013, there's this famous Instagram shot of him and some of the Gold Coast players forming a little prayer group, and they would pray before games. And he spoke about this on the Footy Show with Sam Newman, about he actually had a small group with these other players in the Gold Coast team, and they would pray before every game. And it's very, very interesting. This came out of a tough time for Gary, because he was getting a lot of criticism in the media, being criticized for going to the Gold Coast and taking money to go up there. He's in a young side that was just new to the AFL, and he was criticized for lacking leadership ability. And out of that came this life group, he calls it, and a prayer group, and that famous photo and interview on the Footy Show. And the scripture that he shares in this photo, and that they spoke about on the Footy Show, is 1 Corinthians 10:31, about in all things do it for the glory of God. And I think Gary Ablett Jr. has done that so well as a Christian, in the public eye and in the eye of the sporting public in Australia. He's lived out his faith. He's been a believer. I mean, does following Jesus make you a better sportsman? I don't know about that. I mean, I played sport all my life, and you know, you can't really pray that you'll win the game, because there may be some Christian on the other team praying that they'll win the game. I mean, who does God listen to? I don't think it really works like that. It's probably a yes and no answer. Following Jesus makes you better at everything. And as Gary himself quoted in 1 Corinthians, that anything we do, doing it for the glory of God, is a good thing. But then in another way, it doesn't really matter what you believe. You can be a phenomenal sportsman, businessman, successful person, despite what you believe. But I think the amazing thing that Christianity does and that Christ does is it gives you an inner peace. It gives you a purpose for what you're doing beyond money or fame or any of those things. And as Gary's fame grew, his profile grew, his money grew, he became one of the greatest players ever to play AFL. Interestingly, his faith in Jesus Christ only strengthened and deepened with that success. For so many of us, our faith fades as we get older, or as we get into our lifestyle and as we start to do things. For most of us, we don't have fame and money follow us, but our faith still drifts. Where for Gary, I think the phenomenal thing and model that he has been is, despite the sporting success, his strength in God has deepened. His willingness to talk about his relationship with Jesus Christ has only grown. You can see a real depth there, that he has his eyes set on something beyond this life, something eternal. And I think that's a phenomenal credit. I think that's probably what makes him the greatest Christian to ever play the game of AFL.